Today is an anatomy day, and we're going to look at the peroneal tendons and some of the bony anatomy that can affect them. And in particular, we'll look at the anatomy of the peroneal tubercle and the retrotrochlear eminence on MRI. So how do you find it? You know, where do you actually look for it? And why is it important? So this is from the Journal of Anatomy. And what it's demonstrating is that we have the peroneal tubercle here, and posterior to that is the retrotrochlear eminence, and in between there is a groove. Now if we look at this on the MRI, what we see is a peroneal tubercle, so the most anterior bump that you will see is the peroneal tubercle, and more posteriorly is the retrotrochlear eminence. Now one of the ways you can also use to differentiate these two is to look at the peroneus brevis and longus tendon. So on this axial scan, peroneus brevis is anterior to the tubercle and peroneus longus is posterior tubercle, and it runs in that groove that we saw on the lateral x-ray. Okay, what about on the coronal scans? On the coronal scans, we can use the peroneal tubercle to differentiate between peroneus longus and brevis. So peroneus longus and brevis lie on either side of the peroneal tubercle on the coronal images. So we have peroneus brevis superior to the tubercle and peroneus longus inferior to the tubercle. So the importance of this tubercle becomes if it's enlarged, as the peroneus longus and brevis tendons move against it, it can result in tendinosis or tenosynovitis or tearing of these tendons. So an enlarged peroneal tubercle, it's important to recognize on the MRI and describe it.